So let's start with news that actually took place this morning, as the Oklahoma reports that Oklahoma is trying to play a game earlier against Missouri State on August 29th. Joe Castiglione told the Oklahoman, "We don't know for sure if we have fans at the game. We don't know for sure if we'll have the game itself. There's no guarantee on anything." But there is precedent. College football season scheduled start, as many of you know, on August 29th, 0 week, which is really a weird name for it. But also, it allows for teams like Hawaii to kind of offset some of their costs by playing an extra regular season game and to play that game earlier, because anybody that's ever traveled to Hawaii knows you that that's an expensive trip and they got to make it maybe 5-6 times a year. NCAA also allowed Miami and Florida to play their game last year during 0 week to celebrate the 150th anniversary of college football. But that's about as good as the news gets. One of the things that you do when you're in this job is read and read widely, at least if you're doing the job well. You never stop reading. And I was putting together a bunch of quotes that I could not tell you about. So here we go. An SEC athletic director told Yahoo Sports, "We just want to get the season started and see where it goes." An ACC athletic director said, "Just trying to keep the lights on. Trying is the key word," end quote. A Big 12 source told CBS, "We want to play as many games as we can." Meanwhile, Kevin Warren, who is the Big 10 commissioner, said, "We may not have sports in the fall. We may not have college football this season." Another athletic director said, "No football is Armageddon." I mean, the doomsday nuclear winter scenario is no football in the fall, no football in the spring, then what? We'll get to that. Now, this gets even worse. Kevin Warren actually got out in front of everybody yesterday to say, "Hey, we're going conference games only this season," which caught literally everybody off guard with that announcement on July 9th. Now, the folks that are bullish on having college football and don't see the COVID as big deal are like, "Why are you even making this decision right now?" But more than that, the folks that are really just all over the place with this and not necessarily saying that they know anything were also caught off guard, which are the commissioners themselves. Because Thursday morning, everybody was on a call to which Kevin Warren gave no inclination that he was going to make that decision and make that announcement. So he got a bunch of guys left holding the bag, which is indicative of how college football has gone about doing this for now 151 years. There is no governing body, and perhaps we need one. But getting back to Warren, he said the biggest thing that this affords us is an opportunity to be nimble and agile in an uncertain time. It all ties back to the health and safety of our student athletes. It's easy for us to manage operations, the schedule, and logistics when we're focused on the Big Ten Conference. Which makes sense, right? Because it's easier to reschedule your games inside of one office as opposed to trying to do that with multiple offices, especially when the NCAA has taken the coward's way out and said, "We're going to just let y'all figure out what y'all want to do. We're not going to actually show any leadership here." And I think about Harry Stamper with that, which I'm going to get to. But there are sports organizations across the country are trying to figure out how to get games going this summer and into the fall. The NBA has just decided we're going to do this and we're going to see how much we can get done. Major League Baseball has done the same thing. MLS's back tournament is also ongoing, right? We're going to have Champions League played overseas in August, and you're going to get a lot of Champions League content. I'm here to tell you, you might get a lot of Premier League content. Well, this college football thing doesn't mess up. But we got 130 FBS teams, right? We got 130 FBS teams across 43 states. That include public schools, private schools, military academies, religious institutions, Liberty looking at you, big cities, small towns, all of it. No central authority. No nationwide commissioner, no quote-unquote college football czar, no governing body. The NCAA just regulates it. They just say, "Hey, here are the rules, play by the rules. You don't play by the rules, we're going to try to enforce penalties on you." Man, look. Ohio State athletic director Gene Smith, though, who was saying, I hope, you know, like, we're going to play in front of maybe 50,000 people in a stadium that holds maybe 100,000 people. And then yesterday says, playing only conference opponents provides us the opportunity to have September available to us. Moving our conference games gives us a better opportunity to potentially get, you know, if not the whole season in, some of the games in. We're all kinds of cautiously optimistic we can have football, and we wanted to give ourselves the best opportunity possible. This comes a day after they suspend voluntary workouts for a rash of COVID-19 cases that they don't want to tell us about, right? It also gets into this bit of the models of scheduling, because we know that the Big Ten is going to add another game to its conference slate, which is going to give them 10 as opposed to 9, which is good. But they are also trying to prioritize big games, particularly in division. So expect Ohio State, Michigan, Ohio State, Penn State to take place much earlier than expected, right? Minnesota, Iowa takes place much earlier than expected. And those models that they are generating that they hope to show next week give something like a schedule and also can allow for an outbreak. Say you schedule a game every couple of weeks and you have to quarantine 14 days, hence the reason that Oklahoma is trying to get a game in on August 29th so that they can have a 14-day cushion before Tennessee and another 14-day cushion for Army. And that putting aside that Oklahoma's got to get under the threshold to get over the 14-day quarantine, for which you would need to take into account if you're traveling to New York right now, because Oklahoma's on a list of states where travelers have to quarantine 14 days before they can travel about the state, seeing as Oklahoma have to go to West Point, which is in West Point, New York, to play at Michigan Stadium. That could be a problem, okay? It gives this real air of, hey, let's space them out. But if you're spacing them out, you also are getting closer and closer to flu season, so you're running out of time, right? Among the leagues, the conference-only model is taking some shape, but not in every league, right? While we expect the Pac-12 to announce a conference-only model, right, we are also waiting on the SEC and the Big 12 to say exactly what they're going to do. Because Alabama's got a season-opening game with USC on September 5th, and 2 months ago, Mike Bone, USC athletic director, said, hey, we expect to play that game. And Greg Byrne was saying, yeah, we expect to play that game too. Yesterday, that took a hit, okay? But Byrne said yesterday that he and Bone are in regular contact, and their plan is still to play that game. Meanwhile, Greg Sankey, SEC conference commissioner, says the Southeastern Conference will continue to meet regularly with our campus leaders in the coming weeks, guided by medical advisors to make the important decisions necessary to determine the best path forward related to all SEC fall sports. We recognize the challenge ahead and know the well-being of our student athletes, coaches, staff, and fans must remain at the forefront of those decisions. Sports Illustrated went on to report that they're going to have the athletic directors meet on Monday in person in Birmingham to discuss fall sports scheduling, and we'll see what comes out of that, though they don't expect to make a decision then. And then there's this thing about money, because the SEC just signed a deal that is going to be in excess of $300 million per year after leaving CBS as the broadcast partner in 2023 with ESPN, who's going to play probably close to half a bill a season to air SEC games. So they have more incentive to try to maximize their exposure at this time when CBS might actually turn into kind of a lame duck for them. Now, Big 12 Conference Commissioner Bob Bowsley told the Des Moines Register on Thursday that the league does not plan to announce a conference-only plan. And Joe Castiglione echoed this one by saying, what is Kevin Warren doing? I mean, that's my words, not his. He was caught off guard by Kevin Warren. But also saying, why would you make that decision right now? Like, we got 2 or 3 weeks, so why not take 2 or 3 weeks? And anybody that ever works with a deadline will tell you, however long the deadline is ahead of you is how long you got. If you got 20 minutes to get to the deadline, it's going to take all 20 minutes. If you got 6 months to get to the deadline, it's going to take all 6 months. That's what it's going to be. But the timeline is the timeline, right? Especially as it relates to that July 15th to July 31 window where they really got to start making decisions, which is next week. Bowsley told CBS Sports, the only advantage to a conference-only schedule is you can spread the games out over more weeks. Doesn't mean you're going to start your schedule the first week of October. You're going to try to start it on time and spread it out so you have more time to recover and more time to get over outbreaks. For whatever reason, the Big Ten felt like they wanted to go ahead and do that right now. And that's how we get back around to OU and Missouri State. which are working in lockstep on their testing protocols and their testing program to try to get that game going and get them down to Owen Field to play that game, for which Missouri State is hoping to recoup $600,000. But that's before we get into the conversation about what the kids think. Because the kids, particularly Oklahoma, want to play. The kids at Oklahoma also have everything to play for. Even if they're not getting paid, they have big time national television that they're going to be on. They have a Big 12 championship they would love to defend for a sixth consecutive time. An opportunity to get back to the college football playoff, which Bill Hancock says, hey, we're going steady as she goes. We are planning to do what we normally do. And we will work with the conferences on what that is. So let's not act like the college football playoff would not go on. Which means that, yeah, if I had that carrot in front of me, I would want to play. But for Trevor Lawrence, Justin Fields, Travis Etienne, your draft eligible players who might risk it, it's going to be bad. But I submit to you, if a child dies due to the COVID, nobody is going to be safe. Nobody's going to be okay. And we're all going to be in a very, very bad way. And that is how you can get from playing a little fall football in September to not playing any until next September. So if you are in on playing football, do everything in your power to be safe, to keep your family safe, to keep those around you safe, and think about the safety of the folks that we really want to watch play football. Because this is a pivotal year. All right.